Hey, this is Ryan from webeminence.com with another website builder review. This one's a long time coming. It's actually a review on the Godaddy website builder. Most of you know Godaddy. They're the world's largest domain registrar. They manage 58 million domains currently and have like 12 million customers. So you can imagine with that many customers and thousands of customers coming on board every day, these new customers who are buying domain names are naturally looking for an option to build their website, so they look to the Godaddy website builder as an option. And since Godaddy doesn't offer a free trial of their website builder, I think it's really important to create reviews like this so you can see the website builder firsthand without having to purchase it first. Now, this is my first review of the Godaddy website builder. They've had many versions in the last few years, and just recently in 2014, released a new version that made a lot of improvements. In the past, I would have told people, and I did tell people, to run as fast as they can from the Godaddy website builder, even if they had a site on the website builder. I usually told people to stop using it, go find a different one, because it was just that bad. Probably because their customers were leaving in droves, Godaddy finally decided to do some major updates to their website builder, and they did make some huge improvements that I'm going to go through in this video. And once you're a customer of their website builder service, you're going to see website builder in your list of services. I'm just going to click launch to launch the control panel for their website builder. And this is what the control panel currently looks like. One of the most important things to talk about is the design themes that they offer. And this is one area where they've really improved. In the past, their design themes were very dated and difficult to use. They have updated them. So once you take a look at them here, you'll see that they're a lot more modern, and once we use a website builder, you'll see that they're a little bit easier to use. And if we just scroll through these themes, you'll see they're fairly modern. I can actually click on them full screen and click around to see how they actually function in a browser. So you can do this before you choose the design theme for your website. It's important to really take some time choosing your theme, because once you start building your site on a design theme, you can't go back and start using a different design theme without losing all your work and starting from scratch. Unlike some other website builders like Weebly that allow you to easily switch between the design themes and keep all your pages and your content intact. There are a good number of themes. There's about 15 to 20 categories here on the left, and there's about 10 to 15 themes in each one of these categories. So I've already chosen an education theme, and once you choose your theme, you can go back to the control panel. And I should mention here that I'm using version 7.0.141 of the website builder from Godaddy. So back on the control panel, you can see a screenshot of your theme. I'm going to click on the green edit site button to get into the website builder and start editing my site. And here's the main website builder screen. You can see your homepage of your website in the main area of the screen. On the left side is a control panel, which you can collapse, and I believe, yeah, you can move it around. At the top, there's a toolbar with some save and undo buttons. You can also switch between pages here and preview and publish your site. It's important to mention a few things about this website builder from a general standpoint. The first thing is that it's a layered layout, so all these different elements you see can be layered on top of each other. So you see, I can just take some of these different images and text elements and drag them around on top of each other. And while this does add a lot of flexibility and it allows you to customize the design, it can be problematic because you need to take some extra time to make sure that different elements are not on top of each other and make sure that all your content is easy to read. Luckily, if you screw something up like that, you can click the undo button a few times to get things back the way they were. You can also lock certain elements. And many of these design themes are just different images and backgrounds that are locked. So here's a locked element that has a lock icon. So I can either click the unlock button over here or the unlock button right on the element to unlock it, and then I can move this element around. All of the elements on the website builder have a pop-up menu. So if I click a text element, I can edit the text. I can change settings like background colors, border, shadow. I can round corners. And I can do that with text and images. Here are the image settings, and each one gives you the ability to lock position. You can send a layer backward or forward to change how it is viewed in relation to other elements that are next to it. Another cool element that GoDaddy offers that I don't see on too many other website builders is the ability to show an element on all pages. So a lot of times a website builder has a header area that shows on all the pages, which has your logo and your main menu, but you can actually click this button here that says show on all pages. And since I did that for this hand image, if I go to another page, I'm going to see that image on every page, and it's covered up by other elements. But that can be very useful for certain elements that you want to have on every page. And then you only have to edit it in one place, and that changes on every page. So the GoDaddy designers have obviously spent a lot of time creating these themes, so most people are going to want to utilize the design that they've created. And you can create these designs yourself using the different elements I'm going to show you. For example, this element here with three boxes is just a bunch of text and box elements that were dragged around. Here's a button element. And they were just placed to give it a nice clean design look. So you're better off using these design themes that they offer rather than trying to design this yourself, which could take a lot of time. So to actually edit and build your site, you're going to click on these different elements, edit them, or drag new elements to the page. I'm going to go to this other page called Services to show you how you drag other elements to the page to customize your site. In the first few elements on the left side control panel here are new page. You can add text, which I did here, and you can change all the settings like I showed you. And then there's image, slideshow, and photo gallery, which I've already added to this page here just to show you how they look. So if I were to click the preview button in the upper right, it's going to generate a live preview of the site. And you can see those different widgets I added, like an image widget, a photo slideshow widget that can animate automatically, or you can use the arrows. And then here's a photo gallery that people can click on to enlarge the images and scroll through. There's also an audio widget here that I just added. It's easy to add a playlist and allow people to listen to music on your site. So if I click exit preview, it's going to take me back to the website builder. And let me show you some of the other widgets that they give you. One is navigation, which allows you to add your main navigation menu to different areas of your site. And there's a lot of settings you could change here. And if you want to change the settings of any of the menus on your site, including the main navigation, you can click on the menu, change the settings. You can also click on menu, which is going to bring up this box where you can reorder your navigation links. You can also indent one of the links to make it a submenu. And you can hide certain pages from view on your main menu. So the navigation is really easy to edit, which is actually a big improvement from previous versions of the GoDaddy website builder. So going back to the website builder screen, I can add a bunch of social share buttons. I can add a Facebook widget here. I can add a Twitter widget just by dragging all these elements to the content area. I can add a Google map. I can add the audio player that I showed you and a YouTube video. I want to go back up to the contact form widget because it's also much improved over previous versions of their website builder. So if you drag that to the screen, they give you a pretty basic contact form with name, email, subject, and message. You can change a few settings of this contact form in general and use a few different presets that they have, like an appointment form, general contact form, and a few others. And you can also click on an individual field and change it. You can change the label, and I could change the type to another type, like multi-line text, multiple choice, checkbox, drop-down, date, time, submit a file. So they make it really easy to create customized contact forms to use on different pages of your website. If I go back to the blog widget and drag that to the screen, you'll see it adds a feed from a blog. One major complaint with the GoDaddy website builder in this version and previous versions is that there's no built-in blog. All that they really give you is the ability to drag one of these blog widgets to the screen that just shows links in an RSS feed to another blog that you create on another blog site. So most website builders, in fact, I think every website builder I've reviewed so far has a built-in blog, and the GoDaddy website builder does not. So that's a huge negative. If you plan on creating a blog integrated to your website, you're not going to be able to do it with this website builder. So the other widgets that are available are really design widgets, like creating buttons, shapes, and lines. So you can create vertical, horizontal lines. I can drag this shape, change the color around the corners, make shadows. So these design widgets are really nice to have, and it gives you the ability to really customize the look of your site using shapes, lines, and buttons. And then the last widget is an HTML code widget, which will allow you to embed HTML code that just renders in the position that you place it. So that's pretty much everything offered by the new version of the GoDaddy website builder. Like I said, it is much improved. I do still think that there's better options out there, and you can see those on my website builder reviews page. Weebly and Wix and Squarespace are all probably better options still than the GoDaddy website builder, even though it is much improved. They did improve it to the point where if someone's already using it, I probably wouldn't tell them to stop using it. But for people investigating starting with a new website builder, I probably would recommend checking out some of the other website builders I mentioned that give an overall better experience. If you have any questions about the GoDaddy website builder, make sure to comment on this video, or you can head over to the blog post associated with this video and I can answer your comments there. If you found this useful, I'd appreciate it if you click the thumbs up icon on the YouTube page, and make sure also to subscribe so that you can check out all my future videos. We will see you on the next one.